And she said, that's more than what you've got. 30 groups, I've actually got a bit of a band to get together. So you're more than welcome to join in this loop. So thank you very, so much for your hospitality. So she said, okay, we can pick up this gentleman. Door and they opened the door into this room. Now you see, the strange thing that happens in the door is that there's such an atmosphere in there, a horrible, scary atmosphere. So what he did, just one bed, a stool next to it, and on the other side was a little table with a little paraffin lamp, and on the little side table was a little book. So he got undressed, got ready for the bed, and he just picked up the book. An old copy of the Bible, and he just opened the front cover and said to Charlotte, my daughter. Anyway, he got to see him again, not open to them. Anyway, he was just about to turn around and blow out the paraffin lamp when he noticed the door handle. They hadn't noticed this before, but what happened was it was also a lion's head, and it was starting to turn ever so slowly. So he looked at it, he was watching it, and suddenly the door came. Slowly started to open, and there was this little girl there in a long silken silvery nightdress. She started to almost glide into the room, and he watched her. It was an absolute amazing rise, and he couldn't bring himself to see her. For the first minute, he just felt speechless at his bizarre sight. And she went all the way down, and she stood at the very end of his bed, and he just looked at her for a little while, and he said, hello, little girl. And she didn't say a word. And he said, hello, little girl. Once more, she said, hello. And she went, I'm not a little girl. I'm a...
Jeez. Jarrah.